First things first.
Nobody's perfect, I'll never try.
Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Analina Khailija and we are back with another video. I just want to say thank you guys for constantly viewing my videos and sharing and commenting and doing what needs to be done. My videos are doing so well and guys, thank you so much. And we have now hit 400 subscribers. We're moving, we're getting there. To my new subscribers, welcome to my channel. I hope you guys enjoy the content that I'm giving out because I am here for everyone. For you as a brother, for you as a sister, for you as a daughter, as a mother, you know, the right things. For you as a friend, I am here. So yeah, today we'll be talking about feminine hygiene. This topic, I feel like it has been swept under the mat for a very long time, or people are... Okay, as we grow up as young girls, we become so ashamed of talking about these things. One thing that made me want to shoot this video is because I've realized how we are being, well, constantly misinformed and how much we don't know a lot of these things. So yeah, guys, and thank you so much for taking part on that questionnaire that I posted on my Instagram and on my WhatsApp. Thank you so much, you guys, because I believe that we all learned something from it, because some of the questions that I was asking, I was actually guilty of those things, but then I only realized later when I did my research that no, girl, what you're doing ain't right. So yeah, we're gonna be talking about all of that. We're gonna start from the exterior, going inside, you know, the underwear that we wear, the food that we eat, stuff that we use for our cookies, our pineapples, our princesses, whatever you call yours. And I hope if it doesn't have a name, you better find it a name, a cute name. Because one thing that I can assure you is that your vagina isn't always going to smell like flowers. It isn't always going to smell like perfume and strawberries. No, honey. It's always going to clean itself out. But here, we're just going to learn how to take care of it without using anything that's scented, because you ain't supposed to do that. You ain't supposed to put anything in there that's not supposed to go in there. So yeah, let's start. First of all, ladies, we're going to be talking about underwear. Remember I said we're going from the exterior to the interior? So I did that. I asked y'all which type of underwear do you guys prefer, and most of y'all said that you prefer cotton underwear, and some said they prefer lace underwear because it allows the cookie to breathe, which is wrong. That is wrong. No. That's what I've been thinking as well, but as soon as I found out that lace underwear is not as good as we think it is, I stopped wearing a lot of it. So, make sure that when you buy underwear, it's written 100% cotton, like this one over here. I don't know what am I thinking, but I think y'all can read that. Because it helps, it doesn't trap the heat and the moisture, it allows the cookie to breathe. Unlike other types of underwear like lace. Lace is 90% polyadmin, polyamide, and 10% elastane. So ladies, anything that is made up of nylon, spandex, polyester, you should cut it. Or rather minimize wearing that type of underwear, because it can actually be the cause of the itching, the infections and stuff like that. Try to wear cotton underwear most of the time, unless you're like me, you don't like wearing a lot of underwear. But yeah, now we move on. Cotton underwear. So what we're gonna talk about right now is shaving and hair removal procedures and products and what we need to use. For those who, well, I use both. I shave and I also use hair remover. And yeah, most of y'all said you guys use hair remover, and some or a few said they use blades. But for those who use blades, I'm gonna recommend this brand, the Gillette brand for blades, because it has a skin guard. And one thing that I've realized is that everything that men use on their faces tends to be, well, for shaving, it's actually good for females to use when shaving, because some things aren't, well, feminine products aren't as, how do I put this, prioritized, but this, because it's going to go on a male's face, they're just going to make it the best, if you understand. So because it has a skin guard, I think every, they're quite expensive, I just can't remember the price, but you should get these. And for those who use shaving creams, oh yeah, when shaving, I use it with this aqueous cream. You can get it, I think, at any pharmacy, even Spar has it. Sorry, it is very good, and Lebang recommended this aqueous cream, and I like it. I've been using it for a year now. And to use hair remover, well, use this, or kind of, what's this other brand, Veet. I've used Veet before, and they are all, I don't think I've ever had a problem before with any hair removal cream. They've all been so good. I've only had problems with blades and whatsoever. One thing that I'm just going to share with you guys, a tip that I have learned, is that after shaving or using a hair remover, don't apply anything on your, on the exterior part of your vagina, because that can cause bumps and they can itch, and sometimes they just tend to be so, you know what I mean. So don't use anything, don't use a moisturizer whatsoever, because I've done that and it has helped me till now. I haven't had any bumps. And when you sleep, sleep naked. Well, I prefer shaving at night so that I don't have anything to wear. Unlike when you shave in the morning, from there you have to wear underwear. Say you wear the wrong underwear, you wear lace underwear, then you're gonna have itchy, bumpy shit on your cookie that's just not supposed to be there. So rather shave at night so that you can sleep naked or sleep without wearing underwear. Don't apply moisturizer, because that's just gonna keep your cookie smooth and healthy. So let's take that one home too. Moving on to sanitary towels, what do you call these things, panty liners, tampons, menstrual cups, everything that's just you know. But yeah, let's keep it together. Right there. We're gonna talk about sanitary towels. I realize that a lot of people like Kotex and Always. Well, I like those two brands too. I don't use a lot of I've never used Stay Free actually. I have used Lilith's panty liners, and I've used, well, I'm currently using their tampons, but I haven't used or explored their range fully. And I also asked y'all if y'all knew what a menstrual cup is, honey, or if y'all have ever used it. Well, I've always known what a menstrual cup is. Well, I only knew it last year, but I never tried using it. I've never tried using it. But now for this video, I just got a menstrual cup, and hopefully I'll use it someday, or probably next month. So yeah, we're gonna be talking about all these things. First of all, I'll be telling you guys about the panty liners that I use. I don't think everyone is aware of this brand, but I have been using this Tina Lady brand for a year now. You can get these at Discam and Clicks. Yeah, my mom got them for me last year, and I totally fell in love with them. I mean, the panty liner is just long enough, and it's so discreet. It like, just, I don't know, you guys, I feel like girls should just feel this and understand what I'm saying. But I love this panty liner. It's like, it's not like other panty liners, whereby when you're wearing a panty liner at some point during the day, you just feel the thingy sticking to your bum, and now you have to deal with it and try by all means not to hurt yourself. But here, okay, I can read from the box. It's secure, fresh odor control and dry, meaning that it protects, it has effective protection. The micro, what are they saying here? Micro fresh pearls reduce the development of odor. And by the way, this is unscented. I don't use scented products, and think everyone should just stop using scented products because they actually increase the risk of getting infections. Your cookie is a very sensitive part, so you shouldn't use anything that's scented down there. Don't. It's not supposed to smell like flowers. It has its own fluids to clean itself out. It knows what to do. You don't have to do anything. All that you need to do is just wash it and take care of it. Don't try to use something else in there. The last one is dry, meaning it absorbs liquids very quickly. So I really like this panty liner, guys. Just look at the size of it. And yeah, man, I think you guys should try this brand out. We are now going to be talking about sanitary towels. My favorite brand is always and Kotex. I've been using those brands forever now. I can't remember when did I start using them. Probably when I started. But yeah, I've been using these two brands. I don't have Kotex here, but I use now, right now I have Always. And for both these sanitary pads, I use the night thingy, Maxi Night something. I don't know what do they call them. But I think I prefer using them because it also depends on your flow. If you're one person like me who's always having like heavy flows when you're on your periods, I think you should go for the night because then you don't really stress throughout the day if you kind of mess yourself up. You get what I mean? They give you the comfort that you need, and that confidence, you don't stress at all. Like, I never stress. So yeah, but these ones aren't the night Maxi ones. They are long. It's the second thingy. The first one is very small. I don't like those. Second one, they are long. And the last one, it's Maxi. You should, I think you guys should really be aware of this whenever you buy. Don't just get there and grab a pack and leave. Check which one do you want, and you should know your flow. You should know your cycle as well. Okay, I'm also gonna give you guys a tip. Here's how the cycle actually works. When you start with your periods, that's day one of your cycle. So say you have your periods for 4 days. You're gonna have meaning it's till day four of your cycle. Remember, menstrual cycle takes 28 days, so it's gonna be 4 days, and then you're gonna have till day 14. After these 4 days, till day 14, then we have our ovulation on day 14. From there, it's you have ovulated, and now your body is just releasing hormones, preparing yourself for your next cycle. So that's just how it works. And yeah, get a note or a diary or a calendar or something, just so that you can keep note of everything, or just to understand your cycle and how it works, to know when is your heaviest flow, when is your lightest flow, and when to use what. So now, guys, we're going to talk about tampons. I know not all of us can familiarize ourselves with tampons, but some people feel like tampons are much easier to deal with. They're not all messy and mushy like sanitary pads. Over here I have these Lilith pad tampons. What I like about them is that they kind of like explained what I've been talking about, when to know when is your lightest flow and your heaviest flow. So I would recommend these ones. I've used them. I'm not a regular user of tampons, but yeah, I like these ones. I don't know about other brands. If you have anything to say about other brands, leave a comment down below and just share your experience. So yeah, because these ones over here, I only use them on my lightest flow though, because wow. As you can see, they give you like the thingy. Purple is for your lightest flow, which is why I got these ones. But yep, now we're moving on to the menstrual cup. I bet we've all been waiting for this one. I have never used a menstrual cup before, but I think it's less expensive, like unlike having to buy pads every month. By the way, I think I got this one for 200 rand. Let's unbox and see. I'm gonna check unboxing it now. This is a size small, your cup size. They said A small cup should be used by women under 30 years of age whom have never given birth. And a large cup should be used by women who are older than 30 years of age or have given birth, regardless of the birth process. Sorry, so y'all heard that? Let's look at this. What? It's so small! Guys, it is like so small. What the fuck? I didn't expect it to be this small. Like, all this time I've been thinking, it's such a huge... Like, guys, I've been thinking that this thing is gonna be like this big. I don't know. Like, so yeah, let's look at the folding for it. They said you should fold it for insertion. I don't know, like this, but it's like the rubber is very rubbery. This is how you fold it for insertion, and then can't touch this thing. No. Be sure to sterilize your menstrual cup before you use it. It is recommended to sterilize your cup by keeping it in boiling water for 3 to 5 minutes. Always wash your hands before preparing to insert or to move your menstrual cup. So, hi girl, like it's very small. Oh, which is kind of a relief. And the only thing that's just messing with my head right now is this rubber. Like, and like it cannot get smaller than this. That's the problem. But anyways, he's a born. I'm really gonna try it. I didn't buy something so that kesatlaho exam or anything. I'm just gonna try it. I also asked y'all if you guys wash your hands before using the toilet, and most of y'all said no. And guess what? I'm one of those people. Yeah, I'm guilty of not washing my hands before using the toilet. The importance of us washing our hands before using the toilet is that we don't make it easier for all these germs that we get from outside to our cookies. No. So it's better when you wash your hands before using the toilet, because you're probably gonna enter the room, touch that door handle, wash your hands, and then sit on the toilet. Do what you need to do, and then wash your hands again and leave, right? So you see, it's much safer that way, and I've been trying to get into that habit, even though sometimes I like forget, be like, oh shit. So it takes only 21 days like to make a habit, so start now and see how far you go. See, tell me if you see progress or whatsoever. But I recommend it because I've been doing it, and you'll use the toilet more frequently when you drink a lot of water, because I also drink like 1 liter per day. I cannot drink 2 liters per day, but at least 1 liter. Drink enough water, cleanses your skin, makes you glow. Especially if you mind your own business, drink water and definitely mind your own business and take care of yourself. That's that. But yeah, I wanna tell you guys about the wipes. I asked y'all if you use wipes to wipe, and only one person said she uses wipes all the time. And I was like, girl, sabawel. But then yeah, I wanna tell you guys about these Femaging refreshing wipes. It's a very popular brand for feminine hygiene products. I think you can get it at Clicks and Dischem and at any pharmacy, because even Swaza Upgeek has this brand. I didn't expect them to have it, but then yeah, I ordered these on Takealot and it was like 160 rands. I use them when I have my nails on. If you cannot find these, if you can't get these wipes, just get like a small pack of any baby brand, to have like at least a small packet of wipes, especially when you have your long nails on, because girl, sometimes I'd be wondering how are some people just surviving, because when I have these long nails on, I just use wipes. It's my only way out of mess. But yep, this brand is very good, so you can get it at any farm.
pharmacy that I can assure you, or you can buy them on Take a Lot. Like I said, you get not only this small pack is 160, you get 6 packs of these with 10 wipes inside, meaning you get like 60 wipes for 160. Meaning, okay, let me not do the maths, it's fine. I mean, yeah, we're now going to talk about period pains and just what do we drink, eat, and so on. The consumption. Yeah. You know, it contributes, what we eat here contributes to what is happening down there. I asked you guys, what do you use for period pains? And a lot of people said that they drink hot beverages like tea, whatsoever, and coffee. And some people said painkillers. And aspirin came up a lot. Some said Nurofen pills, which I also use, and only one person said she uses Harlemenses. I don't know, you guys call it Haramans, but it's actually written Harlemenses. I use this too, and balsam. I use the balsam copifa. These boxes are very familiar, I guess so, but yeah, I'm surprised that it's written not for children 0 to 12 years, but I knew these as Nitlhagatsabana, but it's crazy, hey, it's insane. So what I do is that I drink these like on the first day of my periods, because usually I have like the worst period pains, the ass cramps, the guys, like, yo, I have the worst on my first day. But I drink Nurofen tablets, and these two, because they say that these they say that Harlemenses is for the treatment of the kidney, the backache, and the inflammation of the bladder, and they say that Harlemenses is for the treatment of the kidney and bladder complaints. So I think in a way our kidneys are associated with our uterus in some way, because it's like only path out like to the exterior. So these have been working. I got this tip from my grandmother. They have been working, and I don't think they're gonna stop working now with this generation. So you guys should just at least try. They're not the best of things to drink. I know they are horrible, they smell, you're gonna burp this thing the whole day. So you can drink it with milk, or a teaspoon with milk, or with wine. I usually drink it with milk. But yeah, if you don't like alcohol, then you can just have it with your milk. If you don't like being a cat, you can have it with sugar and you'll just be ayoba. But then yeah, if not, then you guys, I'll just I'll just upload a picture, or a screenshot, or a screen recording rather, of what everyone said they use for period pain, so that you can catch something there, because a lot of people really interacted and I am so grateful. But yeah, we're now moving on to what to eat. I think you guys can see that I have pineapple. I don't know if it's visible there, but this baby girl over here, this is the name of my cookie. I really, like, guys, I love pineapple so much. Like, I love pineapple. My addiction with this fruit started way before I even knew that it actually helps with keeping your cookie fresh and stuff like that. But then, yep, you guys should eat a lot of pineapple. Drink, whether you find pineapple juice, pineapple salad, anything that's just associated to pineapple, eat pineapple, eat your pineapple, and be healthy. And yeah, it's very good, and I think it's the healthiest thing to actually always have with you. Anyway, okay, and one other thing that you guys should always have, which is very good, is cranberry juice. Any brand, it doesn't matter which brand, as long as it's cranberry juice. I actually drink a lot of juice. I don't drink a lot of soda, but then in most cases I'd rather have, you know, vitamin C like type of juice. So cranberry juice is the girl, is that girl that you have to drink, like. Ooh, yep.
Last thing is plain yogurt. My mom and I only found out about this last year. Like, I really didn't know that plain yogurt is that important. But then, yeah, at least I think it would work in terms of yeast infections and stuff like that. Just have yogurt, eat enough yogurt, but not too much of it, because as you know, too much of everything isn't good. But make sure that you have plain yogurt, you have like anything, man, that is kind of related to having being a supplement of vitamin C type of thing. Have that. But anyway, guys, that's that from me. I hope you guys enjoyed this educational video. It was so educational for me as well. Like, I've learned so many things. The only thing that I didn't address that I almost forgot to address is taking a dump and sitting on that toilet for an extra five minutes, whether it's 5 minutes or 30 minutes, dagama, don't do that, because then you're increasing the risk of you getting an infection while sitting on that toilet. Whether it's your toilet at home or a public toilet, don't do that. Do not do that, because you're just gonna get an infection. So as soon as you're done, do what you need to do, pagama, and get out. And then whether you dump, wiping after taking a dump or after peeing, always wipe from back, from front to back, not back to front. Because when you wipe from your back to your front, you actually, from your anus, you're bringing that dirt to your vagina. So do not do that. Cut it. Stop it. Make a habit. Like, I'm giving you guys 21 days from today until the 21st day to actually wash your hands before using the toilet, and just wiping from front to the back, not back to front. Because we have adapted to so many bad things, and we have to unlearn a whole lot of things and just take care of ourselves in a proper way. Because sometimes we're doing things, but we're not doing them right. And you doing it doesn't mean that it can help you or it can prevent you from having certain things. But then, yeah, you guys, that's that from me. Barbie Bria, Onalina Barbie, whatever you call me. Bon, that's that from me. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And please do interact with me on the comment section down below. Tell me what you learned. Share this with your mom, your sister, your aunt, your cousins, your girlfriends. Just share, and I really appreciate it. And don't forget to comment if you're a new viewer, and to like this video if you actually liked it. I'm hoping to see you guys next time with another video. Bye.